No flare-ups for a second day in a row. Firefighters are holding and building the lines in South Lake Tahoe, but the danger is still high. Here are the very latest numbers on the fire. 3,100 acres and more than 200 homes have burned. Containment remains at about 55%, with full containment still expected on July 3rd. The cost to battle the fire has now jumped to $5.7 million. U.S. Forest Service officials should update this information coming up in a press conference in the next 30 minutes.
Meanwhile, the fire crews are continuing to work very hard to protect those fire lines, but they say they are not out of danger yet.
KCRA3's David Bienick is live in South Lake Tahoe, where he spent all day on the front lines again. David?
Well, Edie, good evening. The ground here has started to cool. There are still 2,200 firefighters out on the lines tonight. They are not declaring victory just yet, but it looks to us as if this firefight has been won. Firefighters were standing guard along Highway 89 this afternoon, watching for the winds to pick up and waiting for the possibility that the Tahoe fire could once again roar back to life.
I've seen plenty of fires where we think that we're doing good and then things change on us. I wouldn't say that we're out of the woods at this point.
But crews have hosed down the hot spots and raked through the coals so much that when the winds finally did pick up this afternoon, there wasn't much more than ash to blow around.
My comfort level, seeing fires for all the years I did, this is looking pretty good.
So now at least part of the focus shifts to keeping firefighters safe. For example, cutting down charred trees before they can fall down on someone's head. The head of the firefight says so far, three of his people have been hurt, including a firefighter yesterday hit by a boulder.
And luckily, it was a broken hand and a broken rib, and he's at UC Davis this morning getting surgery.
Firefighters walking through the burnt-out woods not only have to be aware of falling trees and branches, they also have to be on the lookout for these deep holes where trees once stood.
Free supplies for you. Free supplies.
The Red Cross has started handing out rakes, shovels, and supplies to people who've lost their homes. But as of late today, most residents were still being kept away. And so the cleaning up and rebuilding has yet to begin.
We love living here, and I think that the majority of people will rebuild because it's a really special place to live.
Back now live, and you're looking at some of the firefighters heading out of the woods at this point. Lots, as I said, 2,200 firefighters still on the scene here, as well as about a dozen helicopters. But the helicopters, they haven't been in the air today, another good sign that the major part of this battle has already been won. Live at South Lake Tahoe, I'm David Bienick. Now back to you.
Yes, several good signs tonight. David, thank you.